Good morning everyone. Today we will study document object model, short form DOM. The document object model is a programming application interface for HTML and XML documents. It defines the logical structure of the documents and the way a document is accessed and manipulated. For example, if we consider designing of a table, we write table tag, then we decide rows. For each row, we use a tr tag. Then for inserting data, I'm using td tag, and then actual data is inserted. This is how we can say it is an example of a DOM, as it is going step by step for defining the logical structure of a data, how it is retrieved or stored. So let's see how we can access a field value by document object. I have written a small code. In this code, I am designing a form. You can see on the right side, form name equals to form1, enter name is a label where a text box is inserted with the value name equals to name. Then br tag for the line break. Next, I am inserting a button in my form, printing a value print over it, and on click event, I am calling a function print value, which is being defined in the script tag. In the function print value, I can see there is a variable name which is equals to document.form1.name.value, where document is the root element that represents the HTML document. Form1 is the name of the form, name is the attribute, name of the input text, value is the property that returns the value of the input text. In the next line, I'm using an alert box for displaying the value which I have accessed through variable name. Now let's see the example. You can notice that I have written the same code as I have explained to in the PPT. So I have saved the document with the name document1. You can run this file and you can see the results. As I am entering the name XYZ, on clicking the print button, I will receive a value welcome XYZ. So on moving to the methods, various methods for the object document object are get element by ID, get element by name, and get element by tag name. Let's discuss each method by using it in the code. So let's move on to the code. I am explaining the first method, that is get element by ID. So first let's see what's in the body tag. I'm designing a form. Again, there is a label, enter number, input type equals to text. Here I'm mentioning the word ID. In the ID I'm passing number, name equals to number, then br tag, then I'm adding a button with the value q. On click event of the button, a function get called, which is get cube. So let's see what is there inside the get cube. I'm taking a var number which is being retrieved by the document object by document.getElementById. You can see I'm using the word number inside the enter number label. The same number will be used in the getElementById dot value. Then there is an alert box which is displaying the result by taking the cube root of the cube of the number. Script tag close. I'll save my document. I have saved the document with document 2 name. I'm running it. Now you can see if I enter a number 7, it will display result 343. You can vary your number and see the difference in results. So it is how our first function on method get element by ID works. Our next method is get element by name. Inside the name, I'm using a field name. As you can see, I have designed a form over here with the values. Male, two radio buttons are designed. for which the name field is common. Again, I am inserting a button in my form where on click event it will call what? That is the function total elements, which is being described in the script tag. I'm taking a variable all genders equals to document.getElementsByName, and the value being passed is gender, and an alert box is being added to calculate the total gender word used in my form. So length will give you the result, all genders.length. Let's run this code. On running the code, you will see the results total gender equals to 2. This means if I will use gender in somewhere else also, it will also calculate that. Let's see the code. Now suppose I'm adding another line here where I'm writing again, the name value is using the word gender. I'm saving my code, reloading my page to see the effect. Now you can see the result is 3. Now moving on to the next method. Our next method is getElementsByTagName. Now this method will help you in calculating the number of similar tags in your text. Suppose we want to count H1 tags. So I'm taking or designing a simple page with H1 where I'm writing this is a paragraph, then another P tag, then another H1 tag for displaying another heading. I'm inserting a button. On click event, I'm calling the function count para, count headings, then button close. Inside the script tag, as I'm using the function count para, that must be defined. So I'm taking a variable total h equals to document.getElementsByTagName. The tag which I want to calculate, that is H1 tag. So inside the alert box, I'm taking total H1 tags, and length can be calculated using a function total h.length. If you want to calculate any other tag, you can change, make the respective changes over here. So let's run this code by first saving it. I have saved the code with document 4. I'll count heading. It will give the result 2. Suppose I want to count paragraphs. There is a single paragraph in it. I will simply make changes in the tag part. That is, here I'll replace H with P. Now you can count the paragraphs here also. I'm using the P tag only once, so result must be 1. Reload your page to see the change. Now total H1 tags are 1. As H1 is being displayed, you can write here again P tags, then press Ctrl S to save the changes, reload your page, total P tags are 1. This is how our various methods of the DOM works. Thank you so much.